Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Algae Corner with me, Dr. West Bishop. In today's episode, we're going to talk about how do you get algae in your system. More specifically, we're going to look at why and how algae appears in your pond. Now, as we've already discussed, algae is almost everywhere. It grows everywhere, and there's likely been algae in your pond shortly after it was formed. However, usually we see different factors that promote its presence and dominance. So algae get around in unique and very different ways. Let's go over some of those ways first, and then we'll talk about some of those factors that impact their ability to move around. So humans move algae around quite a bit, whether they know it or not. There's algae that move around with all sorts of human activities. Boats, for example, other recreational activities, ski-doos and snorkeling can all have small algae on them, algae spores or algal cells that dry on them and move from water body to water body. Fishing equipment and waders, fishing poles even, and lures can move algae from one water body to the next. But it's not just humans. Many animals can have a play at moving algae around. Animals can transport algae directly or indirectly to different bodies of water. Turtles, for example, have a bunch of algae that grow on their shell that move from one body of water to the next. Fish can eat and excrete algae in different areas of a pond. There's algae that grow attached to different animals, even like muskrats and beavers and even alligators. But one of the worst animals for moving algae around are waterfowl, geese, for example. Not only can algae stick on their feathers, stick in their fur, stick on their feet, and geese can transfer algae from one body of water to the next, algae can actually pass through the guts of waterfowl. Some algae are designed to be tougher, to have protective defenses against the intestinal system of waterfowl. And again, these algae can pass right through and get excreted out into new bodies of water where those waterfowl fly to. There's been documented algae moving thousands of miles with migration of some of these waterfowl in particular. Now, additional thing is algae don't necessarily even need animals or humans to get around. Many algae have spores or cells that can arise into the atmosphere, into the air. You know, there's one group of scientists that went up 500 feet in the air and collected a sample and put some water and nutrients in it, and it started to grow many types of different algae. So again, just through the wind, just algal cells moving in the air can grow many types of algae. Those can settle in different bodies of water and grow. For example, you've probably seen algae growing in your swimming pool or in your bird bath or just a cup of water that was left outside for too long starts turning green. Again, these likely originated from the atmosphere, from the air, and dropped down into that water and started growing. Now, as with most everything, there's a seasonality to algae. Different times a year, you may have different algal types. Now, just because you just started to see one type of algae doesn't mean it wasn't there before. Doesn't mean it just arrived. Some different conditions may have allowed it to become problematic or grow to densities that made it so you could see it or become a nuisance. Water quality, for example, is one of these key factors. Nutrient levels, if you had a big flush of nutrients that came in, that one type of algae you had that you may not have known started to grow and started to produce nuisance levels and higher density and biomass. And certainly temperatures, the seasonality from cool springtime conditions, which some algae like, to later in the season, warm conditions, different types of algae like. So again, there's many different ways you can get algae in your system, and there is a seasonality. Different algae may dominate at different times of year, and certainly other factors that may impact their ability to achieve densities that cause concern. So how do you prevent algal growth in your water? Well, there's no 100% way to do that. It's very difficult, again, to offset birds from coming in or atmosphere from dropping down into your system. But there are some things, some proactive things you can do to try to keep algae from getting into your water body, such as, you know, don't dump bait buckets in, you know, wash your boat before you take it from one water body to another, wash off your waders, try to keep, if you don't want them in there, try to keep the geese and the swans and the ducks from, from jumping from pond to pond because they can carry a lot of algae too. But again, there's no 100% cure to preventing algae from coming in your system. In terms of preventing it from getting out of hand or growing some of the nuisance and noxious types of algae, which we'll talk about in the future, nutrients are very important. So anything you can do to use less fertilizer, only use as much as you need, try to decrease leaves and grass clippings from entering your pond, try to decrease that nutrient pool in your system can certainly limit the growth of some of these algae at achieving nuisance densities. So keep in mind that some algae are good for your pond. Again, some can move up the food chain. Some are good for producing oxygen and moving up the food chain to grow big bass. But many types of nuisance algae, you know, some thick mat formers and the scum formers, or even if you get too dense of a good type of algae, it can still cause dissolved oxygen issues. So keep an eye on the types of algae you have and how dense they're getting, because many types aren't good for a system, don't move up the food chain, and actually can be potential toxin producers that pose risks to humans, pets, livestock, even the fish and invertebrates in your system. So today's episode, we summarized how do you get algae, where do they come from, how do they get around, and briefly summarize some of those factors that may cause them to get out of hand. Thank you for your time today, and thanks for checking out this episode of the Algae Corner with me, Dr. West Bishop.